Hello students, we will see today classification of the tractors from the course farm machinery and power. So there are different types of the tractors. First of all, we will see the types of tractor according to the constructions. First is riding type of tractor. Tractors in which a driver can sit and drive. Example is general purpose four wheel tractor, which is most popular all over the world. Second is walking type of the tractor. Operator walks along. Garden tractors, power tillers. The second type of drive. Track type of the tractors. Instead of wheels, one track is fitted on either side. This track gets drive from sprocket run by rear axle shaft. No steering gear fitted. It is done by applying brakes to one side of track with other track moving. Example is bulldozer. Then wheel type tractors. Commonly used tractors run fast and wheels absorb field shocks. Two wheel tractors used for small farms, hilly area and gardening purposes. Three wheel tractors popular 5 to 20 years back. Hand single or dual wheel fitted at the front end in the center and are good for shorter turns. Four wheel tractors. Most commonly used tractors, also known as all-purpose tractors, small size tractors 15 to 25 HP, medium tractors 25 to 45 HP, and large tractors which are more than 45 HP. This is the figure of three-wheel tractor, and this is the figure of four-wheel tractor. Classification of the tractors based on the purpose in which utility tractors specific purpose field operation and is designed for plowing and driving and other equipment through its PTO drive not manufactured at the present. All purpose tractor designed such that it can might practically all the demands of agricultural purposes such as plowing, harrowing, leveling, pulling, sowing, thresher operating, pump operating through PTO shaft provided with 3-point linkage. Orchard type tractors only used in orchards. Tractor can move easily and safely in between trees. Garden tractors in the range of 1 to 10 HP and are very small in construction, used in gardens. Rotary tillers, these are walking type tractors used in small fields or on hills where ordinary tractors cannot work efficiently. Earth moving tractors are heavy in weight and strongly built, available both in track and tire type, used for earth moving work on dams, quarries, constructional sites, etc. This is orchard tractor. This is garden tractor. And there are some factors while selection of farm machinery. So when any farmer goes to the market to purchase farm machinery or the tractor, he should consider the following factors while selection of it. The first is trademark, second is trade name, third is model, fourth is repair and spare parts availability of the spare parts, fifth is design, sixth ease of operation, seventh ease of adjustment, eighth adaptability to work condition, nine quick change of units, and ten is maneuverability. Then we will see some terms when the tractor does the farm operation. The first term is theoretical field capacity. So basically, when tractor does any farm operations like plowing, harrow operation, cultivator operation, sowing operation, it requires some time. So according to the width of the implement and speed of the tractor, theoretical field capacity and actual field capacity depends on that. So whatever may be the field covered by the tractor in unit time based on rated speed and covering 100% of its rated width. So see the definition of theoretical field capacity. It is the rate of field coverage of the implement based on 100% of time at rated speed and covering 100% of its width. Means in theoretical field capacity, the time loss like turning loss or other losses of the time is not considered, like width loss. We always consider 100% of time utilization and 100% of its rated width. Theoretical field capacity, its unit is hectare per hour and is calculated W multiplied by S. W is width of the implement in centimeter. S is speed of tractor in kilometer per hour divided by 1000, and you will get theoretical field capacity. Means the rate of coverage of that implement by using tractor. It is TFC, theoretical field capacity, where TFC is theoretical field capacity in hectare per hour, W is total width of the plowing in centimeter, S is speed of plowing in kilometer per hour, and if the efficiency in given, then it becomes practical area covered. Means if the field efficiency we know that, then we can find out if the field efficiency is given in percent, then we can find out the theoretical field capacity. WS multiplied by 1000 multiplied by field efficiency. Field efficiency may be 80%, 75%, 90% of that particular implement by using tractor or bullock power. It is in percentage, that's why it is divided by 100. Then theoretical field capacity can be calculated by this formula. Another formula for TFC is when W is taken in meter and that speed is taken in kilometer per hour, then instead of 1000, it should be divided by 10. Then also we get TFC in hectare per hour. So this is also another one definition of effective field capacity. Effective field capacity is also known as actual field capacity, which is always less than theoretical field capacity. It is the actual area covered by the implement based on its total time consumed and its width. Means in effective field capacity, whatever may be the time loss in turning, which is considered, and turning loss or the width loss, these types of losses are considered in effective field capacity. So theoretical field capacity, means TFC, is always greater than EFC. Effective field capacity is also known as actual field capacity. For the definition of field efficiency, it is the ratio of EFC to TFC. EFC is also known as AFC, effective field capacity to theoretical field capacity expressed in percentage. So field efficiency is equal to EFC divided by TFC multiplied by 100. Estimating the cost of the tractor power. In this, we have to see different factors. The cost of tractor is divided into two heads, which is fixed cost and the another one is operating cost. So what is fixed cost? Fixed cost, in that there is depreciation is there, interest on the capital is considered, then housing, insurance and taxes. All these factors are also considered in fixed cost. Then it is a operating cost. Operating cost is also known as a variable cost. In this, fuel cost, then lubricant cost, lubrication cost or oil cost, then repair and maintenance and wages of the operator. This cost comes under operating cost or the variable cost. Well, we will see first fixed cost. In that, what is depreciation? Depreciation means it is the loss of value of machine with the passage of time. When we purchase tractor today and after 10 years or 5 years, there is loss of value of machine because of friction and wear and tear, and because of use, there is loss of value of the machinery. It will become less. Such type of value is known as a depreciation. It is calculated by C minus S divided by L into H, where D is depreciation per year, C is the capital investment, means initial cost of the machinery, S is the salvage value, which is taken as 10% of the capital cost, H is the number of working hours per year, L is service life of machine in tractors. Generally 10 to 12 years are taken as service life of tractors. Then interest. Interest is calculated on the average investment of the tractor, taking into consideration the value of the tractor in the first and the last year. So it is calculated as C plus S divided by 2, means the average of C means the capital cost and the salvage value, multiplied by interest, it should be in percentage, and divided by H. H means service life of the tractor, where I is interest per year, I is percentage of interest per year. Housing. Housing cost is calculated on the basis of prevailing rates in the locality. In general, it may be taken as 1% of initial cost of the tractor. Initial cost means you can say the capital cost of the tractor. Second is insurance. Insurance charge is calculated on the basis of actual payment to the insurance company. Generally, it is taken as 1% of initial cost of the tractor per year. Then taxes is also on actual taxes paid per year, and generally it is taken as 1% of initial cost of the tractor per year. Then we will see the operating cost. In this, fuel cost, it is calculated on the basis of actual fuel consumption in the tractor. Lubricants, charges for lubricants taken as 30 to 35% of the fuel cost. Repairs and maintenance, it is taken between 5 to 10% of initial cost of the tractor per year. Wages of the operator is calculated on the basis of actual wages of the